If you'd allow me to whisper the little gray left in my hair with the words of my quivering lips, I'll tell you a story. I could hear as droplets of memories filled the rivers of my mind as rains mixed with thunders of sobs which triggered the rise in tides, causing it to overflow the banks of my eyelids as tears, but first eroding in me the continuous desire to discover my purpose. You see, it was early, around twilight, yet too early to lay in the vehicles of my bed, wrap myself with my bedmate, my blanket, allowing me to be driven to that kingdom there, kingdom where every other thing seems possible, peaceful and beautiful, the kingdom of dreams by Sleep the Chauffeur. I was tired. That day, I had decided to run around a football field 15 times. You know, that football field that sits behind Parcelo's big brown house where Great Boys 11 come to train off in. I had heard of their justifiers, and I thought maybe this could be my breakthrough, so I was prepping for it. But once, twice, three times had I gone round it when pains like stab pierced through my lungs. I couldn't breathe. My heart was racing fast. My head was hanging high. My mouth was open wide. I collapsed. And I laid on this bare bed floor like a fallen branch. This wasn't for me either. You see, the day before, I went to the beach, and I observed as the sea whitened its pebbles on the cliff. I took a stroll down into the deep, searching for what was supposed to be mine. I was dependent on willpower, trusting my beliefs. I knew my purpose was inbuilt, but how was I supposed to discover it? So I figured, why not lay in bed and watch as the masons of my fears, coupled with the labors of my self-doubt, build its own tower of Babel towards the heavens of failure, with my past as brick and my addictions as mortar, because I was devastated. I didn't know my purpose, didn't know what my life was going to look like in, say, 5 years, and the worst part was I didn't know who was going to help me. But I knew something else. I knew I needed to look someplace else, look to the inventor of my spirit. I needed him to lead me down the street of hope, the hope for discovering my purpose, the reason for my existence. So since then, next day, every day, before the sun could spill its beams of rays into the soils of the atmosphere, I was up, with my knees touching the ground, my hands lifted, I fasted, prayed, laid. Days fade, and as I prayed, languages got mixed up. Babel had collapsed. Now here I stand painting pictures on the frames of your minds with my words. I am a misfit. I can't fit in a box fixed by a boss for me to sit in. But now here I stand painting pictures on the frames of your minds with my words. I am a misfit. I can't fit in a box fixed by a boss for me to sit in. So I ask you, what is your purpose? What do your soul seek its pleasure? What do your heart beat for? What do your arms long to grasp? What do you perceive as priceless happiness? What do you hope to excel in? What is your shape? Or are you as the old me still figuring out what it would be? So I ask you, what is your purpose? What do your soul seek its pleasure? What do your heart beat for? What do your arms long to grasp? What do you perceive as priceless happiness? What do you hope to excel in? What is your shape? Or are you as the old me still figuring out what it would be? Maybe you should fast about it, pray about it, dream about it. And as you pray about it, God will definitely talk about it with you. For you have been made for more, made to soar. Don't belittle yourself. Don't fit in a box fixed by a boss for you to sit in. For when God created you, he said, hey, be fruitful and multiply. And replenish the earth, and subdue it. Just replicate this, and you'll savor every bite of joy that comes with walking in your purpose. For when God created you, he said, be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over it. Just replicate it, and you'll savor every bite of joy that comes with walking in your purpose. But remember, like he shone from like stars on earth. How many of us have seen that movie? Like stars on earth. You see, we are all unique in our own way, so no need to copy. But if you allow me to whisper the little gray left in my hair with the words of my quivering lips, I'll tell you, prayer is potent. As we pray, life is formed. As we pray, purposes are bed. As we pray, things come alive. So pray.